he's old school. Used to be a drunk dude. Businessman, nah, everybody love that dude. BobbyBuck.com, BobbyBuck.com. Go ahead, I dare you, log on. Yep, he's old school. Yep, used to be a drunk dude. Businessman, now everybody love that dude. BobbyBuck.com, BobbyBuck.com. Go ahead, I dare you, log on. BobbyBuck.com. Go ahead, log on. Log on. BobbyBuck.com.
Hello, hello. This is Shauna Sterling, and I am at the Bobby Buck Show. I am in the studio. We have some special guests that's appearing today all the way from Arizona, California. And we'll be bringing them in just one moment. But first, I have Suzette in the studio with me right now. And she's going to give a little bit more information about these young women that came all the way from Arizona from that's working on actually their master's degree with social justice and human resource program that they're in an internship here in Los Angeles. Suzette?
Yeah. Hello. Good evening. Thank
good
you
evening.
For having
good
me. Yes, these are some fabulous young ladies that I met at LA CAN, and LA CAN stands for Los Angeles Community Action Network. They are a local human services justice program serving the community, serving the Skid Row community. And I met these young ladies just last week while I was by there. And the young ladies, I'm from Arizona as well. And so that's how our conversation initially struck up. And they are going to a school in Prescott, and they are studying social justice. And I was intrigued by that. I mentioned to them, was like, I went to school at Arizona State University, and I mentioned to them, wow, when I was in school, I just remember, you know, there being a criminal justice program. So they were mentioning to me their program. It intrigued me. There was another young lady who can't be here tonight, but she'll join us another night once we kick off our show next week, Ladies on the Mic. And the professor with the other program here at Cal State University, she actually implemented this program, this social justice program, at her school. And Karen and I believe was going to be here tonight. She's the professor who implemented the program. But it sounds like a fascinating program. We're very much interested in learning more about what they're doing, about the program, and how it's serving our community, and so on and so forth.
Okay. Now, we have some of them in the studio right now. Let's bring them in. Come on in, ladies.
Hey.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Hey.
Hi. Oh, wow. Look at all the beautiful women.
Welcome.
And you brought Uncle Bean in behind you. Have a seat.
Welcome.
You Karen?
I'm Zoe.
Okay. Hi, Zoe. I'm Shauna.
Oh, hi, Shauna.
Hey, Amber.
Put your headphones on. Okay, we have four beautiful young ladies.
Five
beautiful young ladies that just walked in.
That's right.
All the way from Arizona, right?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Okay, what I want to do first is introduce yourself, starting with you, Zoe.
Hi. My name is Zoe Hammer, and I'm the director of the Master's Program in Social Justice and Human Rights at Prescott College, and I really appreciate you inviting us here today.
No problem. We enjoy having you.
Hi, I'm Muriel. I'm Muriel, and I'm one of the students in the program, and I'm really excited to be here, too. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
My name is Alyssa. I'm another one of the students in the program.
I'm Ashley, and I am also studying the social justice and human rights.
Okay.
And my name's Autumn, and I'm another student in the program.
All right.
Welcome, ladies.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Would you like to start the questioning off?
Yeah. Well, first of all, tell us a little bit about, I was just trying to mention to our audience in regards to LA CAN, Los Angeles Community Action Network, and a little bit about what it's about. But why don't you all tell us a little bit about how you're connected with LA CAN and the work that you're doing there. Okay. Whoever wants to speak first, I'm not sure.
Well, I'll start.
Go on.
Go ahead.
Okay. Well, this is Ashley, and I am doing work with LA CAN. I am doing the Homeless Bill of Rights. Homeless Bill of Rights work with LA CAN, and what we're doing is working on a draft of the Homeless Bill of Rights to ensure that everyone has rights, including homeless people, and everyone has rights to like rest and legal representation, and as well as adequate, used to hygiene facilities.
Okay.
They're working on drafting a new Homeless Bill of Rights. And also we are working on work with Venice Beach curfew. And we did some outreach at Venice Beach last weekend and spent some time on the beach and realized that it was really evident that we were needed there.
Okay.
There's a lot of policing there. So
awesome.
That's what we're doing there.
Awesome.
Great.
Zoe, can you like also kind of do an intro on how you came about getting connected with LA CAN, how you brought these ladies here, and you know, a little bit about how the program so far?
Sure, absolutely. This is a new master's program. This is our third cohort of graduate students. The point of the program is to combine experiential education, so hands-on learning through working education, with an intensive, rigorous academic social theory segment. And this is our kickoff. We do an intensive orientation in Los Angeles. I've been working with the LA CAN, bringing students to LA CAN to learn about their organizing model, because it's such a incredibly innovative and effective organizing model, for the last 5 years. And 3 years ago when we started the program, I approached them and asked if they would be interested in having students do small, containable within 3 week research projects. And they were excited about that and generously invited us into their organization, where the students get to make a contribution to their work, but also importantly, they're there as students to learn about the analysis that they've built there and the organizing model, and you know, the day-to-day impacts of how globalization and gentrification in the city and the intensive policing and prison atmosphere in Los Angeles are impacting their communities, and how they're developing projects to fight against those systems. So,
awesome! It's great work. I mean, it's fabulous. I'm really happy to have you all here. That you're, you know, and I love that the idea of this program in general. I think it sounds like an awesome program to be in, and how stimulating. So,
can you tell our listening audience what is LA CAN?
Yeah, again, LA CAN is Los Angeles Community Action Network. They do outreach in the Skid Row community as far as serving human rights needs for the homeless population within the Skid Row community. They help. They've got several initiatives that going on. They have a civil rights initiative. They have a housing initiative where if citizens are having issues, either homeless people or people who are in Skid Row housing buildings, where they and maybe they're having issues, you know, they have attorneys who can help them with their housing needs. Civil rights portion of it will actually they take part in a lot of the activism as far as trying to get more affordable housing for homeless people, trying to find things like that, and as well as things on the streets with homeless people who are living on the streets, as far as if they're feeling like injustices are being done to them, where they can actually they can go to LA CAN to, again, if they need to see an attorney or if they need to just, you know, get some more outreach support, then they're there for them. LA CAN also has a DWAC program, coalition, which is Downtown Women's Coalition, and that's an empowerment group for women that's evolved, I believe, in 2001, and that's how I'm somewhat connected to them. And then we're really trying to build, you know, a strong women's support group in Skid Row, and to serve the needs of women, because there are a lot of needs, and our needs aren't necessarily one and the same with the needs of men. And so I feel, you know, I'm very much compelled to be part of it, because I wanna see things move forward for us. I don't feel that, you know, women, disadvantaged women, and so forth, necessarily have a strong voice, you know, on the larger platform. And I'd like to see them move forward.
Okay, ladies, how much longer do you have here in LA?
We actually just have another week as of today.
Oh, wow.
And after this program, we're going to be going, after our time in LA, we're going to be going back to Tucson in Arizona, actually, and spending some time connecting everything we've been learning here to issues of border militarization and other issues around educational justice, as well as, you know, incarceration, just getting a lay of the landscape over there in terms of organizing around immigration rights and all of the issues there to connect with here too. So,
awesome.
Land of the week.
That's great. That's great. Okay. Have you enjoyed being here in LA? This nice hot weather?
Definitely. Yeah. Definitely. No, we've been for sure enjoying it, especially compared to Arizona. It's really not that hot.
Well, it's hot to us. You know, we're like that. We're spoiled like
yeah.
that.
Ashley, I saw some fabulous pictures on your Facebook page of some, seems like some fun places you've been going to.
Yes, I saw that.
Yeah.
I saw that you
yeah.
shared those.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so what do you guys do here after the internship to relax?
At the end of the day.
At the end of the day.
After the internship?
Yes.
At the end of the day, when you're done, you know, at LA Can during the day and so forth, your projects, what do you do at the end of the day?
That's a good question. I mean, we're all piled into a pretty small house right now. We're actually staying at St. Elmo's Village, which is a huge opportunity. It's like a artist, activist community, which is super exciting. So we're all piled in there on our Therm-a-Rests. We've been making lots of group dinners together.
That's awesome.
And continuing to work on stuff at home.
That's awesome. Like I mentioned, I'm from Arizona. I went to Arizona State in 1982, 85. I wish there was some kind of, you know, something like this when I was back in school. That was what initially, you know, I connected with you all. That way, because I just thought, this is just great that you're doing this, that you've brought these young ladies here, Zoe. I think it's fabulous, you know, that you are reaching out. You know, I don't know if Arizona even has anything like a LA Can, which is like really, really amazing. You know, I mean, really, right? But so I just think it's fabulous that, you know, you found the connection outside of, you know, Arizona to try and you know, make this happen. I'm also interested to know what you ladies plan on doing post-school. Like, what do you plan on doing with your degrees?
I could try and answer that. I'm not sure exactly, but I do know that I'm interested in doing movement building work, you know, and really looking at ways that different struggles can come together and build coalitions, which is another reason why I've been really interested in this program too, because it's so focused on giving us tools to do movement building work by learning from the groups that we've been working with, you know, by learning from those who are most impacted by economic and racial injustices are the ones who are doing this amazing work. And so I think for me, it's just, you know, continuing to build that in exciting ways.
Yeah. Okay. Anybody else?
Yeah, I mean, just echoing what Miri has said, it's been a huge opportunity to be able to work with groups like LA Can and Works and learn from people like the YJC and Critical Resistance and all these people because we're learning from the experts. We're learning from people that are, know their own experience best. And I think in the future, I would like to just continue developing myself as a tool to be used in all of that. Continue hopefully in organizing spaces and then maybe teaching someday or something.
Do y'all plan on staying in Arizona post-school, or are you going to, like, move outside, like, California or go someplace else? What do you plan, Ashley?
Well,
we haven't spoken at all there.
That's okay. You might.
Don't be shy.
Right? Go ahead.
Well, I know that I joined this program because I believe in the human race, and I know that I want to share stories. And the means of how to do that, I'm not quite sure how I want to do, but I know that I want to travel. So I'm not quite sure where I'll end up. But
good for you.
Yeah.
Okay. Amber, did you want to?
Oh, in terms of places, I mean, I definitely
want to come back to L.A.
Yeah, no, I could definitely spend some time here for sure. No, definitely like the West, Southwest. Okay. It's been that's where most of like my experience with all of the education I've been getting in this realm has been from. So I definitely feel like I want to stick around and give back from what I've got.
Awesome.
Okay, awesome. Well, I was talking with Zoe on the phone today, and she was telling me about all this awesome stuff that you guys are learning and that you're working on your master's. And so she asked me, what did I do? And I told her one of the components of my foundation is human rights, teaching it to the youth. So what I did, ladies, is I brought my books to share with you.
Oh, wonderful.
Oh, my God. Thank you.
And so here's some books for you guys to take.
Awesome.
Thank you so much.
It,
one of them tells the story of human rights, because that's one thing that I teach the kids is, where did human rights come from? And then the other book have the human rights in it. And it's kid-friendly. Mm. And it's amazing that if you ask the person, what are your human rights, they don't know the basic human rights. Mm-hmm. They don't know that housing and food is a human right.
Right.
You know, so I commend you guys on the subject that you're learning.
Yes.
Keep up the good work.
Absolutely.
Keep up the good work. Absolutely. And I am very happy that you guys came in. She found you guys.
Yeah, we were led. We were led. We were led. We were meant to be. I want to, you know, and it's funny how we all kind of collectively have a human interest in, you know, and serving people and making sure. I loved what you said earlier, Ashley, in regards to, you know, you feel everyone has the right to, for, I can't remember exact words, but you said something about entitlement. Everyone has, you know, the right to equality and so forth. And one of the, you know, I also, I chaired a restorative justice program for first-time juvenile offenders in my hometown in Arizona for several years. I sat on a board. So, you know, I mean, you know, there collectively we all have something here. And I would love to read my women's empowerment poem to them also before they leave, if that's at all possible.
Okay, I have one more question.
Sure.
What has been the most enlightening to you with the people here? I want you to speak.
There you go. And what's your name again?
Alyssa.
Alyssa. Mm-hmm. I need to hear from you, Alyssa. You're so quiet over there.
I know that we all feel so fortunate and lucky to work with all of the people in the groups that we've been able to work with. And I think one of the most enlightening things, and maybe one of the most important lessons that we're taking away, is that similar to what Autumn was saying earlier, that it's the people that are the members of the impacted communities that are the experts of their own experiences, and just the lesson in how valuable it is to work with them and to use their knowledge and the insights that they have in order to make a difference.
Right. Awesome. Okay.
We're going to let you read your poem.
Thank you.
Then after we hear her poem, we are going to listen to The Man in the Mirror.
When I first met you all, I had given you a flyer. I facilitate a women's empowerment group every Tuesday at 12:30 p.m. And so anyway, here's the poem that I wrote on the back of my flyer, and it's called Standing Tall for Dignity and Equality. I am not a liberated woman, as I am just a woman who yearns to be free. I wish to live free from the bondage of inequality, longing for equality that is yet to be. We've come far, but how far we've yet to come. Women are still striving for their equal sum. Whether we're sitting in the White House, Donald Trump Plaza, or up in Beverly Hills, to the lows of the Appalachians, run-down sawmills, or the Catskills. Whether your zip code is Manhattan, New York, or here on Skid Row, human dignity should not come at the price for only those who can pay concierge prices and can afford exquisite means. I humbly tell you, my voice is my power. It fuels me each day, gives me the strength which surpasses none. Instead, allows me to be more of my equal sum. Please know, I'm just one voice. I've won no battles. The battles have yet to be won. This voice is just another gift God gave to me so I can stand tall for dignity and equality.
That was beautiful. That was beautiful.
Thank you.
That was beautiful.
Thank you, ladies, for coming.
Thank you.
Okay, I have a song that I like to hear. It's called Man in the Mirror.
Make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. As I turn up the collar on my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. I see the kids in the street. Not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them need? A sonorous disregard, a broken bottle top, and a one-man show. They follow each other on the wind, you know, 'cause they got nowhere to go. That's why no one wants you to know.
I like playing that song because it is so true. It's basically really talking about take a look in the mirror. Let's take a look at yourself. Let's see what you're doing to change things. Mm-hmm. Because if you're messed up, you're going to put messed up out.
All right now.
So me and Bobby, we have a lot of long conversation and discussions and debates. And I came up with a poem called We Are Enslaved by Our Own Ignorance.
Mm.
And it goes like this. Because you don't listen. Because you talk too much. Because we're not educating ourselves. We are enslaved by our own ignorance. Look, people, stop feeling sorry for yourself. We have babies having babies and our men in jail. Stop pointing the finger and stop thinking the world owes you your ancestral land. Stop thinking you know it all and learn to listen. Learn to take responsibilities for your own actions, whether good or bad. Learn to work smart and not hard and make it come to pass. Learn to pray to your higher power. Learn to love self and family in just that order. And only then you are on your way to freeing your enslaved mind. As you talk about what people are not doing, stop and take a look in the looking glass called a mirror first to see if that person is free from his or her enslaved mind. And only then you are on your way to freeing your enslaved mind.
Amen. Beautiful.
That was something that Bobby pushed me to do because I'm not a writer.
You were compelled, huh?
And I when I do things like that, I'm speaking from my heart, because people are very quick to point the finger at what someone else is doing or what someone else is not doing, instead of saying, okay, wait a minute, let me look at myself first. What part do I play in this?
That's right. That right there.
Is my mind enslaved? Am I working for what I want? Or am I waiting for someone to give it to me? And we have a lot of that going on. And that's why I commend you ladies. You are going to school. You're taking a stance. You're looking in that looking glass called a mirror at you first. And I love it. Yeah. I love it, love it.
You're our future.
Yes, you are our future.
That's right.
You are our future.
And our hope. Our hope.
Yeah. So if you have anything to add to that, add to it. No?
Well, I mean, I'm not saying.
Go for it.
Y'all down on Skid Row are our hope and our future.
Yeah, I love it. That's
nice. No, really. I mean, everything that y'all, I mean, just especially with DWAC and everything that you do, see that it's just, it is incredibly inspiring. And like, the only reason that we have hope is because of looking back on folks that have been doing, I mean, participating in the struggle for hundreds of years. So
awesome.
It helps.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Well, down on Skid Row, we need to bring more awareness, because a lot of times when a person gets down on Skid Row, they just feel like their backs are up against the wall. They have no rights. They're being treated bad. They're being sent on this rat race. And some of these things all of them need to stop. We need to bring the tone level up, because the tone level is so low on Skid Row until a person doesn't know how to dig themselves out of the situation that they're in.
Yeah, but you lose that hope. Some of them lose that hope. Yeah, that's for sure.
So I commend you again for doing what you're doing, because it's going to help.
Excuse me. I just want to say that, you know, you all make me so proud being from the state of Arizona. You know, I mean, that's I'm just so proud of you all that, you know, that we share the same family state and so forth. So, again, I just want to shout out there, because, you know, Arizona is not necessarily known for, you know, what we are all doing here. So it's a beautiful thing.
Definitely not.
It's a beautiful thing. So anyone, you guys have anything else to add to what you're doing, what you're going to do, where you're going from here?
Zoe, how were you compelled to start this department anyway? I don't think I got that.
Oh, well, it's interesting that you say you wish there was something like this at ASU in 1982, which is when I was in college also.
Oh, wow.
And I was compelled. It wasn't just me who started this program.
Okay.
It was a whole committee of people.
Mm-hmm.
All of us combine our scholarship and teaching with long-term engagement in activism and social justice projects.
Mm-hmm.
And we created the program that we wished had been available for
okay,
us when we were in college. if we had known then, you know, what we know now.
Yeah.
If we had had the understanding of the breadth of the kinds of projects that are going on across the country, if we'd had the opportunity to meet and learn from, you know, incredible organizers like the people at LA CAN, you know, might have helped us do more faster.
Yeah.
And so that was, and another reason is I have so many students who become so passionate, so many undergraduate students who become so passionate about these issues as they learn about them. And I wanted to create a track for them to go further. And also to equip students with the really useful skills and knowledge that can allow them to go to work for an organization, a community-led base-building organization like LA CAN, and immediately understand what it's about and understand what kind of strengths they can bring to it, and what they can, and what they always have to learn from those organizations.
Who knows? Maybe you'll get me back in the state of Arizona. I'll move to Prescott and study under you.
Oh,
I'm driven. How many universities actually have this program as of right now? Do you know?
As far as I know, we're the only graduate program that I know of that takes an experiential approach to studying critical social theory.
Okay.
as far as I know.
Now, does Cal State University have an undergrad program? Is that what's up?
Oh, I'm not from Cal State. I'm right. from Prescott College.
Right.
And I don't know much about Cal
State. Oh, I'm sorry, because one of the other ladies I had met there, Amber, who was supposed to be on tonight, and she'll be with us another night, but she's studying at Cal State, and she's studying a similar program. I don't know.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, I think she's an undergrad, though, so that's why I was just curious. But anyway, we'll get more information from her another time. Sorry.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Okay, ladies, thank you again. We have Vicky who walked in. This young lady has some lungs on her. Oh, my God. And she has just walked into the studio. She over there blushing.
All right now.
But that's okay because I know Miss Vicky can blow.
All right, I'm ready for you, too.
How you guys doing?
Hello now. Good evening. Welcome.
Thanks for having me, huh?
No problem. So what you going to sing for us today?
Girl, you know I'm going to sing Dr. Feel Good.
Girl, right, okay, let's get it.
Turn it up a little bit. I don't want nobody always sitting around me and my man. I know you know what I'm talking about, girlfriend.
I do. Bella now.
I don't want
too young to have a Dr. Feel Good.
That's right, that's right.
Your Dr. Feel Good are your books.
So. That's right.
Your books and your Bible.
That's right.
That's it.
That's right.
When you get my age. you can understand.
Yeah, those college boys will derail you now. We know how that is.
But you know what? I used to sing this song all the time, and I really didn't understand it. Mm. You know, it's like now when I sing, I understand what I'm singing. I understand that I'm able to tell the story because I've been through it, and I can relate, and I've had experience, you know.
Give us your testimony.
And at 50 years old, I mean, you know, I mean, hey, it's about time. But no, you know, I've, you know, had my life's ups and downs, and, you know, Aretha, that's my girl, you know. Mm-hmm. But I like her because she talks mess and sing at the same time.
Okay.
You know, and
she keeps it real.
And she keeps it real and raw, you know, and tell it like it is, you know. So, right now, I'm working with a promotion, music production company, and I'm doing a Aretha tribute.
All right.
They have me as the number one Aretha tribute artist right now. So,
and that makes good sense. You really show her a lot of respect.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you don't want to hear her sing that. Oh,
I really do.
She blows.
Well, I mean, I sing other songs, too, don't get me wrong, but Aretha, you know, that's my style of music, you know.
I ain't mad at you.
Because I can relate, you know, in life's events and things that I've been through in my life and stuff, you know, it's like I can relate when she say, "You're no good, heartbreaker. You're a lie, you're a cheat. I don't know why." Then she'll sing, "I let you do these things to me." Mm. I can relate to that, you know, and I could be like, "Yeah, my friends was telling me he was no good." And, you know, I could understand respect, R-S-E-P-C-T, you know. I could understand you got to think and, you know, so...
My sister, I believe all of us can relate to that to a certain extent.
Especially those of us in, I'm the same age as you, so especially those of us in your age.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. And who are single especially, too.
All right. We have a phone call.
Ooh.
And so let's call her.
Yes.
Who are we talking with?
This is Antoinette Greer. I run a support group for women that are diagnosed with breast cancer.
Hey, Antoinette, how are you?
Hi, I'm fine. How are you?
I'm blessed. So how can we help you?
I was invited to the show to say a little bit about an event, a fundraiser, and a fun time that we have coming up October the 18th. It's going to be a bazaar and casino party fundraiser. October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so we really want to get, you know, the community involved in awareness, and we also want to raise funds for the programs and services that we provide.
Okay.
The event is going to be October the 18th, a Saturday, from 4 p.m. to 9 p.m. The tickets are on sale online on our Facebook page as well as our website. It's going to be in Compton at Kina's Place. The address is 16708 South Thorson Avenue in Compton, California. One of our sponsors is actually Bobby Buck, and he does a lot of work with Skid Row. We're going to have live entertainment, vendors, and meals are going to be included in the cost of the event. So I wanted to share that today.
Okay, what's the cost? What's the cost of the event?
The cost is $30.
And your Facebook page?
Our Facebook page is My Sister, My Friend, Breast Cancer Support, as well as our website. It's www.mysistermyfriendb.cancerssupport.org.
Okay. All righty. Okay, thank you very much, Antoinette.
That's in Compton.
For giving me that opportunity to promote that event here.
It is in Compton. You.
Yes.
Oh, Antoinette.
Yes.
We need your phone number, sweetie.
Okay, phone number is 866-542-6312. Again, that's 866-542-6312.
Okay, and October, from what I'm understanding, is Breast Cancer Awareness.
Yes, it is Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Okay, and so those who want to support Antoinette, give her a call. Go to our Facebook page. We need to bring more awareness to breast cancer.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Yes, we do, because African Americans are suffering at a marginal rate. There's a lot of monies available for research, but not very little is available for support. So we have to, mm-hmm. you know, charity begins at home. We have to support one another to resist.
Absolutely. Great.
Okay.
That's wonderful.
Can you tell us a little bit more about your support group, Antoinette?
Yeah, we're actually a survivorship organization. Support group is one of the services that we provide. We also provide, those support groups are held every third Saturday of the month, either at our office location or at St. Mary Medical Center. So that information is also available on our website. We do educational outreach. We support sisters when they're in treatment that need to get to treatment and want someone to go with them. We support them through transportation. We also help support them financially because a lot of the women suffer a loss of income. So we try to link them either to resources when we run out of funds. That's why the fundraising is so important. We link them to programs like Project Angel Food, where they get hot meals delivered every day because a lot of women are single parents or, you know, live alone or lose their income or their ability to work during treatment. And some are actually denied disability while they go through cancer treatment.
That's
so
sad.
It's imperative that we raise awareness and money to cover ourselves. And I'm a survivor of 12 years myself.
Snap, snap.
Yay, that's great.
Yeah, God is good.
God is good all the time.
Yeah. Okay, so.
So I have my own testimony.
Yes, you do.
And I thank God every day. And that's why I reach back, you know, to help other women get through this as well, because the whole family is affected by cancer.
Right. Okay, so in October, we're going to have to get you down here on the Bobby Buck Show so you can elaborate a little bit more about breast cancer treatment and the after facts and things a person need once they are diagnosed.
Yeah, I recently wrote a book. It's called Ask Antoinette. Mm. It should be available on Amazon in about 2 weeks.
Right.
Bobby did help me with the promotion of that book as well. And it's an ask and answer, Dear Abby type. The questions have been posed to me in my tenure, and I've answered those questions for women, so I'm sharing that in this book.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And I believe when we talked, Antoinette, you said the proceedings of that book is to go
it's
with.
It's going to go to the support group, of course, to the survivorship organization, because, okay. again, I'm giving back, and this is one of the measures that I'm using is my own testimony and some of the inquisitive inquiries from women with breast cancer or women who are seeking screening. There's various types of questions in this book.
Okay.
Appreciate what you do there.
Yeah,
it's a rewarding experience in itself to know that you're making an impact on the lives of men.
All right, Antoinette, thank you. And
thank you for letting me share.
And we need your support. So about 2 weeks, look on Amazon for her book and support breast cancer.
Yeah, definitely. You know, charity begins at home. So I started in my own community assisting women with getting screening. We have several screenings going on from some of our partners that are free to people who don't have any insurance or low income. So I'll be sharing some of those dates and locations when I come back, too. So you can also find some on our website and Facebook page as well.
Okay. Thank you, Antoinette.
Thanks for calling in.
Thank you.
All righty.
Okay.
All right. Vicki, I have a question. Mm. Bobby wants you to elaborate a little bit more on your Aretha Franklin deal. Hmm.
Well, you want me to elaborate on my Aretha Franklin deal?
Yeah.
Well, I go out and I do a lot of karaoke and sometimes. And this one particular night, I went out and I wasn't going to go. And I ran into a guy by the name of L.C. Davis. By the way, he's an L.A. blues man. Call him L.C. Davis, and he does blues. Okay. And I've done some work for him. That's where Resonance started.
Okay.
And I was working with him and his manager, Mary, and started doing, you know, more shows and getting more gigs. And I had a debut April. But the thing with Aretha, like I said, I was out singing, and a lady had approached me. And she has a music production company that she's bringing tribute artists, you know, like people like Bing Crosby impersonator, Aretha impersonator, Gladys Knight, Barbara Streisand, you know, different people that look and sing like the original artist.
Okay.
And so I was out that night, and she gave me a card and asked me to call her. And she asked me, would I be interested in doing Aretha Franklin impersonation, no, putting the wig on the gown and, you know.
I see it.
Yeah, and so I told her, I said, sure. And so she said, well, we have to do, you know, there's a couple things we have to do, you know. We have to check your background. I need these references, I need to do this, I need to do that, you need to do this, you need to. I'm like, why are they, you know,
I just want to sing.
You know, why is
they
she
trying
do-
to make sure you're not a criminal.
Yeah, she, you know, she wanted to check references, she wanted to make sure I sung at the rooftop, I won Best Singer, she wanted to make sure that I was out here performing with these people and interacting with these, out here, you know, doing this, you know, choir directing, all this experience and stuff. So she really, you know, like checked fakes. Facebook, you know, check, you know, checked everything that she could check about me and find up about me. And so whoever the people that she talked to, you know, they gave her the thumbs up.
Okay.
And so when she had heard me sing Rocksteady, she said it blew her away.
She said,
you sound like Aretha, you know,
and
you got the look, you know. So
like
we went from there, and the next thing I know, I have a web page. She threw a web page together, put a video together, and all this stuff, you know. And I'm like, wait a minute, you know, hold up, wait now, wait just a minute.
Okay.
You know, let's take our time with this.
So you have a website up?
Yeah.
What's your website? What's your website?
It's the website. It's promotional music production. www.promusicprods.com.
Okay.
And you click on tribute artist, and it has the, like the Supremes. It has, you know, like different people, you know, imitating the original artist.
Right.
And I have a page up there, and it tells you a little bit about me. And then it has a couple of pictures, and then it has the video and has pictures between the video of me singing Dr. Feel Good.
Okay.
Thanks, so Tingo.
People check that out. And from what I understand, we have another caller. Caller?
Hello.
Hello. Who are we speaking with?
With Claudia Perez.
Hi, Claudia. How can we help you?
Yes, I'm just calling in. We're on Skid Row right now. We're helping out the community here. I was put on air by Bobby.
Okay.
Great.
So what are you out there doing?
We're handing out clothes and shoes, and we brought about 80 burgers and waters and snacks.
Okay. Is this something that you're doing personally, or you have a business?
We have an organization called LA on Cloud 9. Every Friday, we have Teen Project, a group of teenagers that get together and give back to the community.
Great.
What corner are you on?
We're on 5th and Town.
Okay. And if you had a wish list, what would the number one thing be on your wish list for your company?
People to volunteer and to come help out as well, just, you know, to come help the community. You know, there's a lot of people in need over here, and, you know, just simple hello or you know, donating items on the streets where it's needed.
What type of items would you like donated?
Food, water, clothes.
Okay. And if
hygiene products.
Okay.
How long are you going to be out there tonight?
We're still here. We pretty much leave until we finish giving everything out.
What time do you come on Fridays?
We're here about 6 o'clock from 6 and on.
Okay, so if someone wanted to donate to your organization, how would they do that?
Well, we have a website, www.lac9.org. And we also, my phone number, you can call me at 323-812-9836. We also have a Facebook. You can connect through all our social media, through our website. Hit us up, and if you have clothes to donate, shoes to donate, anything you want to give back to somebody who could use it, you just, you know, either you come with your items and give it back, or, you know, or just join us.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. And
is your Facebook page Cloud 9 as well?
It's LA on Cloud 9.
Okay.
Okay, thank you, and keep up the good work.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to go on air. Appreciate it.
No problem.
You know, if I could just say, I'm just so moved by how, you know, we're all, how we've all been directed to, you know, like our passions and so forth. And I think it's beautiful, you young ladies, before we leave, I just want to make sure that I say it's beautiful that you all have found your purpose at such a young age, and that's really important. It's really important. It keeps you focused, keeps you directed. You know, I pray that God keeps you on your paths and keeps you well and healthy and happy.
Okay. We need to wrap this up. We need to do final contact. So your name, your contact, and your contact information.
Oh, you can email me at zhammer at Prescott.edu.
Okay, ladies.
Muriel Manning, and you can email me at miriel.manning at Prescott.edu. That's Prescott.edu.
Okay, next.
My name is Alyssa Studi, and my email address is ALLISSA.STUTTE@student.prescott.edu.
Okay, now Vicki.
You can reach me at Vicki Lee Robinson, VickieLeeRobinson at yahoo.com, or you can go on Facebook and look me up and check me out. And if you want to check out the video on my webpage, you can go to www.prosicprods.com and click on Tribute Artist, and you find out more about the website and my webpage as well.
All right. Ladies?
All right. My name is Ashley, and you can email me at Ashley, A-S-H-L-E-I-G-H dot Hall, H-A-L-L, at student, and then dot Prescott dot edu.
And my name is Autumn, and you can find me at Autumn, A-U-T-U-M-N dot Chase, C-H-A-S-E hyphen D-E-M-P-S-E-Y at Prescott.edu.
I'm Suzette Shaw, but you'll find me here next Friday night at 7 p.m. as Ladies Take the Mic with Bobby Rowe, and we'll be talking real women talk here on Skid Row. So join us then. If I could also... just mentioned Rock, Paper, Scissors is a play that'll take part tomorrow evening. And it's regards to what does it mean to be a woman and experience Skid Row. So that'll be at Art Share LA, 801 East 4th Place.
Okay, and I'm Shauna Sterling, sitting in for Bobby Buck. I am from the Sterling Family Youth Foundation. And for more information on the Sterling Family Youth Foundation, you can go to bobbybuck.com. It's free. And you'll find out all the events that the Bobby Buck Show's doing, all of the events, and a little bit more about the Sterling Family Youth Foundation. And we will see you next week, same place, same time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Log on, log on, log on, log on to BobbyBuck.com. BobbyBuck.com. Log on, log on, log on. Log on, log on, log on to BobbyBuck.com. BobbyBuck.com. Log on, log on, log on.
www.facebook.com.